Rocket, Hiro Woka, better known as Yukio Mishima, was unrivaled as the most outstanding writer of his generation. In November 1970, he performed the most spectacular, feat of his career. While his father was held captive, the commander of the Japan Self-Defense Force, he imposed to the assembled troops to debunk the post-war history that changed and robbed Japan of its identity. Shouting a greeting to the emperor, he plunged his sword to his abdomen. One of his disciples prevented him, thus completing the ritual.
Ah, to what deals I fancied myself as a genius, destined for an early death, and as the final heir to the Japanese beauty, as decadent among decadent, amid the beauty of the kamikaze.
He plunged himself down to the lower depths.
I would behave normally, but I'm just sick inside.
He married an aristocrat's daughter and was the tender father of three children. He was the same Pasur who said,
"I allow to sit on Rococo furniture, wearing a rubber shirt and Orimas. You know, my idea of a lifestyle."
And yet, he was virulently opposed to the infiltration of the Western culture of Japan. Yukio Mishima, the same master of letters who produced 40 novels, 18 plays, published 20 short stories and essays. He was nominated 3 times for the Nobel Prize, denounced literary life as effete and antithetical. Yukio Mishima, the same patriarch, a fervent nationalist who used politics as a vehicle for his fantasies and eventually his madness.
So we saw to another Teto Nakai Parade. I watched him raving and I couldn't help but to think how he was so tired and how stooped his back was.
Ah!
to make sure that the general will not commit suicide. It's not good enough. All right, rest to go.
Hi, please come in. The general is waiting, but I won't take you any longer. The general is ready. Please sit there. Hi!
Nice to see you again,
General.
Oh, please sit down. Please sit down.
General, I bring my men here, but I wanted them to have the honor of meeting you. I'd like to introduce to you to Ogawa, Morita, GDP Goga, and Proko. We just finished our exercise in Mount Fuji. During our exercise, some of our men were injured. And these four distinguished themselves for carrying the injured men down the mountains.
Oh, is that so?
Yes, General, and I wanted them to have the honor of meeting you. Later, we will have our regular Captain Ogai meeting, in which they will receive a commendation.
I follow.
That is why we are wearing our uniforms today, because we are holding our monthly meeting.
Tell me, what is this sword with the guard with you? Did anybody ask you about it on your way in? I'm not quite clear on the rules on shore, but as we don't carry them anymore.
Oh, the sword? It is okay to carry this sword. It's just a military sword, an antique. In fact, I carry an expert's authentication, which says here that it's an authentic 16th century blade. Goseki school.
I see. And it has someone saying it, hasn't it?
Yes, it has. Do you want me to get it out?
I see. It's superb. But I haven't seen anything like it in private hands before.
Oh, of course, and it's the last one that you will see!
What kind of game is this?
We'll go in and find out.
Hey! Open up!
Out! 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 Now take a look. Take a good look. If you do not leave, I will kill the general.
Stop this fooling. Calm yourself.
I said out!
Stop this play acting.
I said out. Take Urida or I will kill the general.
We do not understand what you want. Tell us!
Take Urida.
What is this for?
General, I have some demands. If you follow, I guarantee your safety. If you do not, I will kill you. And kill it, Harakiri.
What are you demanding?
Read our demand to the general.
All soldiers. Not even an inkling. You have no interest in this. I have lost my dreams for the Jedi.
I salute the Emperor. Tenno Ikabanzai.
Tenno Heikamazai!
They did not hear me.
Germany were to win the war. I want her to win. I look at culture from a historical point of view, and it seems to me that the gods seek to make history more interesting and amusing as one epoch succeeds another. Even if this war should end with defeat, Japan will succeed in conquering the greatest step forward in world history. In an ideological point of view, to imagine defeat is the greatest romance.
Yasuda held that historical reality was unimportant, and that its emotions and events was more interesting than the events themselves. He argued that it was irrelevant whether a hero is righteous or not. The enlightened man would not commit himself. For such a being, he could neither be a defensive defeat or a complete victory. He could be both winner and loser at any game. Kimitake was attracted by the Romana on its emphasis on death and destruction. In conclusion of the irony, death, it was death, the world's destruction was the ultimate value. His own fantasies had run on similar lines since childhood. Yes, and definitely, he was not solely influenced by the Romanadis' thinking. What he said, that in his own ideology, it was death, that is the ultimate value, and was not insufficient for him.
And my son, as hardly needs pointing out, I progressively turned my back to the preference of the age, abounding in an antithesis, old-fashioned, clothed in a weighty solemnity. It did not lack nobility of a kind. It has the same ceremonial, grave face marching through other people's bedrooms, but it has the same dread as elsewhere. During the early years of time, I mean war, rather, I learned to smoke and drink. Or shall I say, I learned the pretense of smoking and drinking. The war has created a strangely mysterious sentimental maturity in us. My journey into life was postponed day after day. That is to say, the war goes on without a slight sign of my departure. Was it not a happy moment for me? Oh yes, of course. Though I felt a slight uneasiness.
The red paper or conscription summons or not, he felt sure that disaster if you took your side. Death to the 100 million. No surrender. As the wartime slogan had awaited the entire nation.
I was writing my last novel back then, when I got drafted back to the army.
Mishima's way of dealing with the situation was to cling to my sensitivity. In retrospect, he could see that he had been foolish, but at the time, it had been Shikita Ganai. Unavoidable. From the factory, Mishima wrote a card to Fumiya Shimizu. He was hard at work translating a one played by Yitz, he said, and was rendering it into a no play. But he gave up the project. His English was not up to the task of translating at the Hawkswell. The Yitz play in question Well, it is not easy to relay and translate his play. He wanted to put reality aside and wrap himself into his own world, the world of tiny, lonely, aesthetic hobby.
Early 1945, the fighting crept closer to Japan. The United States Naval Forces bombarded Leyte in the Philippines, and a landing was effected. The United States Armed Forces overran the country. Mishima continued to work in the factory. He continued to work in the kamikaze factory in Gumei Prefecture. He still wrote, and in February 1945, he published part of the Jose in a magazine.
I was probably very, very happy at that time. I had no responsibilities. I can write anything I want. I don't have any critics. I have no competitors to contend with. I don't even think about it. Yet, I don't have any responsibility for myself.
Late in the evening of February 15, 1945, Mishima was visiting his parents in Tokyo. He was then on leave from the factory. His akagami, or the red paper, arrived. He was to report for duty at Shikara and prepare to leave the following morning. He composed his traditional issue, or a small note of farewell, to his family.
And I said, "Father, mother, Mr. Shimizu, and all my classmates at the Gakushuin, and all my colleagues in Tokyo Imperial University, thank you for your blessings. And to my younger sister, Mitsuko, and to my younger brother, Chiyuki, you must draft your work to our parents. And to you, my younger brother, Chiyuki, join me in the Imperial Army. You must serve the Emperor. Tennoe Kabanzai!"
When he left the next morning, his mother wept bitterly at the gate of their home as she saw him off.
Even my father seemed little, no, dejected.
Meanwhile, Mishima wrote, "The youth boarded the train for Kansai in the Osaka Kobe area. And during the long ride, the long 300-mile ride, a cold he had caught from the factory became much worse. And by the time that he reached the family home of a close friend in the village of Shikara, their legal residence, he had such a high fever that he wasn't able to stand. After the night's rest, dosed with medicine, he made his way to the barracks the following morning."
Was my own current of art in action. Why should a man be associated with beauty if you are heroic, violent, death? My answer is, such is the beauty of the Suicide Squad, which recognizes beauty not only in the spiritual sense, but by men in general, in a more dramatic sense of. The type of daily life for me was a very vital word is corruption, being the most difficult and abnormal state to live in. With death in mind from day to day, focus each moment upon inevitable death. To make sure one's worst foreboding so excited that one's dream of growing. The beautiful death, earlier in the living, had also become possible. I was beginning to dream of my game of it as a fighting man. But my dreaming with a Jedi, I say, my arrival with the army would be finally influenced only by death. My age pursued me. Murdering behind my back. How wrong, but in fact. What am I seeking is the tragedy that I had once lived. If one broke deeper still, was concerned with blood, the words could never pass to flow. Only through the group, I realized, through sharing the suffering of the group, could the body reach the height of existence that the individual alone could never attain. The group must be open to death, which meant, of course, that it must be a community of warriors. We were united in seeking death and glory. It was not merely my personal quest. I had no vision toward something that, if I were alone, would have resolved back into muscles and words. I was held fast by the power of the group and rent me away to a far land. Hence, there would be no return. The words are valued to be found only in the pure realm of fiction. Words used for political actions are soiled words. To revive the traditions of the samurai and the way of the warrior, which are so vital in Japanese culture, I have chosen a way without words, a way of silence. My aim is to revive the soul of the samurai within myself. I should like to describe an episode that my divine soul adapted upon. As samurai took a group of about 30 members to the foot of Mount Fuji. It was in mercilessly hot day, and under a glowing sun, all of us worked hard in combat exercises. After a bath and supper, several of the young men gathered in my group. There was a sound of thunder in the distance. From time to time, lightning flashed across the deep purple fields. Directly outside our window, we could hear the first part of crickets. After a long talk about how to command the attack squad, one of our members, a young man from Kyoto, brought out food in a beautiful domestic bag. He then began playing for us. It was a beautiful and moving melody. As I listened in sheer rapture, it crossed my mind that for the first time in the course of 20 years, the two Japanese traditions had come happily together. I drove on many highways to trade. Views I had never seen before opened up for me and enriched my experience. But the body is doomed to decay. Just like the complicated motor of a car, I for one will not accept such a doom. Please mean that I do not accept the course of nature. I know I am going against nature. I know I have forced my body up to the most disruptive path of all. The sun was enticing, nor was to I keep my thoughts away from that night of visceral sensation, away from the swelling of muscles encased in solid skin. It was commanding me to construct a new and sturdy valley in which my mind, as it rose little by little to the surface, was grim and secure. The dwelling was a tan, lustrous skin and powerful, sensitive and irritating muscles. It was thus that I found myself confronted with those bumps of steel. Heavy, forbidding, cold as the sunset of night, and it had been still further than death.
Mishima did not make a great boxer, but he enjoyed the difficult training at the training camp. This aesthetic is the most important. I believe it was the strongest influence on Mishima. And the wellsprings of his decision to commit harakiri. Traditionally, harakiri was done by a samurai who was to show his loyalty to the emperor. But Mishima did it. Yes. It was individual and were connected to his long-held aesthetic, his heart's longing toward death and night and blood.
They threatened our culture. They threatened civilization. And that is why I did it.
There is no one I can respect in Japan today. And I believe that the emperor is invaluable. He is the only person with a mysterious existence. The emperor, the works of art, the Shinbun itself, are symbols of purity. I want to associate my own works to that of work of a god.
By giving part of your blood, you swear to the loyalty of our organization. Are you joining us? Does any of you have venereal disease? No one?
Oh,
very good. Tukokoko Nippon! Pass it down to him.
Do you think that war comes over 20 years?
recently more and more students have wanted to fight. Just look at the streets of Tokyo. What do you think of it?
And why did you wait for 2 days and 2 nights outside the palace?
Because these very men, love and respect the emperor from the bottom of their hearts.
And why do you compare us to Senta? Are you terrified of us, Tetsuo Nakai?
I am terrified.
Are you a guided spy?
Guardian spy!
Guardian spy!
Spy!
I am terrified. You all scare me today.
That kid, that the very, very kid, was arrested 82 times by attacking Samba barricades.
Captain Kai, outside. They're walking slowly right straight to us, towards us. I think they're all guerrilla ready. They have P4, P6 walkie-talkies with them. The one with long wavy antenna. And some of them are carrying a Japanese armalite, or Japanese weapon, the good weapon. And they're wearing American-style fighter helmets.
Well, of course, if you're going to walk in this beautiful snow alone, you will go crazy!
And how do you make exception now for the Tate no Kai?
Well, it was very, very difficult.
Difficult to stay secure. Tsushima, you write a great deal about the Emperor. The reason for this is that the Emperor does not exist. His non-existence constituted an absolute beauty. But why then do you play the fool all the time?
Oh.
You should stick to aesthetic instead.
Oh.
Instead, he starts fooling around, and the beauty of which is that the Emperor embodies is destroyed.
You want to keep your image of a beautiful emperor and keep me in my study?
I want to ask you about the emperor. If he happens to fall in love with a woman other than the empress, what should he do? He cannot be respected in so many ways, and one must feel empathy for him.
I really believe that the emperor should have kept mistresses on her bed just to like you. And let me just emphasize this. The reason why I built Tate no Kai is simple. To bring balance to Nippon. And if one says that one must to die in November, he must take responsibility for that. One must to die in November. And it is the same with the written words.
These words are scarcely ambiguous. Early in April 1970, Mishima secretly formed a group of students within the Tate no Kai who were to assist him in his 20th century version of the Shirbuden incident. The members of the group were, in addition to Morita, were Masayoshi Koga, Masahiro Okawa, both 21, and students of the universities in Tokyo. This group of four, Mishima, Morita, Koga and Ogawa met secretly, frequently changing their rendezvous in order to avoid rousing the slightest suspicion. They began to lay their plans. And on his desk, he wrote a short note.
Human life is limited, but I want to live forever.
My guess is that Mishima chose to die on November 25, because that was the day on which he was to hand over the last installment of his fourth book of his long tetralogy, The Sea of Fertility. It was the deadline for the manuscript, and Mishima, as a rule, stuck rigidly in his schedule. What kind of book
was he able to write at the same time he was planning his death? It might be seen as an attempt at justifying and explaining what he did at the last message to posterity. But that is only one aspect to a very complex book. It certainly reflects the desperate state of mind in the last year of his life. It ends with catastrophe.
Memories like a phantom mirror. It sometimes shows things too distant to be seen. Sometimes it shows them as if they were here. Only with age did one know that there was a richness, an intoxication even, in each drop. The drops of beautiful time. Like the drops of a rich, rare wine, and time dripped away. If this is true of his purpose, in the decay of an angel, his harakiri simply stopped time for him, and his physical beauty therefore would...
Stop! Tenoy Kamansai! Tenoy Kamansai!
This is the end.